this is Lady Boulay, and I hope you're having a most marvelous day. Thank you for your support. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Thank you for your thumbs up, for your comments, and thank you for sharing the videos. Thank you for all you do to support the channel. And yes, we are commanded to love one another, whether we want to or not, or whether we agree with each other or not. Today, I want to talk about an email that I received. And yes, my email does work. Email me at LadyBoulay8596@gmail.com. This email was from a young lady, a young black woman, who was concerned that Latino men are demeaning and degrading black women on social media. This is not something that I would normally talk about because I don't like giving energy to other people. But she seemed so concerned about it that I decided to respond to her request. So her concern is that Latino men are doing the same thing on social media that black men are doing, demeaning and degrading black women. So the Latino men have seen that black American men, the manosphere, the red pill, and the save yourself black men, and the passport bros, all of these men have blown up on social media by demeaning and degrading black women. So I guess the Latino men said, hey, this is the way to go. Go after black women. Their own men are trashing them. So nothing wrong with us doing it. So that's what they're doing. And that is what this is about. So let's take a listen to what these Latino men are saying.
Baby, I can go date an Indian, a Hispanic.
As an advocate for the Hispanics, we would like to politely decline this offer. She doesn't know how to cook or clean, and she argues about everything. No, thank you.
The Latino guy says he declined that offer of Tawana. You know, and within the comment section of this video, other Latino guys are saying the same thing too. They said, you know, I speak for the Latinos, or as an advocate of Latino, I'll pass. That's what they said. They said, nah, we don't want them. The reason why they don't want Tawana is because they see how messed up her community is. A nation or people can rise no higher than the moral position of their female. That African proverb basically means that if your female is destroyed, so is your community and your people. And it's true, because when you take a look at the other groups who have their females in order, they submissive, they play the role. Guess what? You don't see their thuns running around fighting and being destructive over street respect. They don't want street respect. They're not in the streets. Only the thuns of Tawana want street respect, meaning they commit crimes just to be respected by other low IQ barbarians.
So this video began with an African American woman, no doubt, addressing black American men who were no doubt putting her down for some reason. So she's trying to prove to them that she can get some other race of man. She was not talking to or about Latino men specifically, but this Latino man jumped in the conversation because he saw an opportunity to get in on what was probably a popular thread. A man that looks like this should not even be on this woman's radar. And okay, Mr. Latino man, what a black woman needs to do first and foremost is to check your papers to make sure you're here in this country legally. So many of you are here illegally, till she would first need to make sure you had your papers in order. Not a dreamer, not somebody that just came across the border because you wanted to. I need to see your papers, Mr. Latino. That's the first thing. The second thing is the Latino community, the Asian community, the white community, the Indian community, every community in the United States of America has the same problems that the black American community has. The only difference is black people are out loud, out in the open, and everybody else is sneaking around in secret, doing low-down stuff, hiding behind women and children and hiding behind the police if you're white. But everybody is doing the same thing. Nobody is better than anybody else. So we can stop that lie. Latino people have worse problems in their communities than black people have. You're just sneaky and you're quiet and you're covering up for each other because so many of you are here illegally. And you have a no snitching policy too. You just don't say it. But you people are committing crimes and doing all kinds of things against each other just like everybody else. So don't even play that game. And as far as criminals are concerned, why do we have so many Border Patrol people, federal marshals, and the National Guard in some cases down there guarding the border to keep criminals out? And don't tell me they don't have a problem with Latino street gangs in Los Angeles. Hispanic children in the school population are on free lunch. They live in projects or Section 8 housing or raggedy trailers 15 to 20 bodies deep. So they have issues in their communities that black Americans don't even have. No achieving black men are on social media talking about the black community and blaming everything on black women. The woman that was talking was well put together. Look at him. His yellow teeth looks like he hasn't seen a dentist all of his life. He's missing teeth, so he is hardly qualified to speak for Hispanic men. Black women should not be getting involved in these skirmishes with black men. Black women have nothing to prove. You should never argue with a man about the kind of man that you can get. You prove it by getting the man. You come on social media with your Latino or Asian or white man and make a video with him and let him tell the black man what you want the black man to know. That's how you do it. But you shouldn't be doing it at all because you don't owe anybody this kind of argument. This is a low vibrational conversation dealing with low vibrational people. Black women are the best educated women in the country. We start more businesses than anybody in the country. Big companies invest in black women. Politicians invest in black women. Educators invest in black women. Black women drive the American culture. That's why black American men and people from other cultures try to eat off of black women's plate, because we are a proven commodity. And these Hispanic men are trying to trigger black women for a reason. Because if black women engage with them, it's going to increase their subscribership, it's going to increase their viewers, their likes, and it will increase their chances of blowing up on social media. This is why people keep coming for black women. Black women have to become more selective about whom to respond to on these social media platforms. You cannot respond to every varmint that comes after you because they're coming for something. They want a piece of you because they're trying to pull up on you. Black women are the standard. If you're the standard, you're the standard. So everybody's going to take shots at you. The young lady that sent me the email sent me several videos of Latino men talking about black women. You have to ask yourself, why? Why are they taking time to talk about black women instead of elevating their own women? And that should tell you something right there. Why are these other people spending their time talking about black women? There is no community in the United States that doesn't have problems. There's poverty in all of these communities. You cannot believe these lies about, oh, these people are the modern minorities and these people are that. They're all doing the same thing. What has to be kept in mind when people talk about black women is that they go after the marginalized black women. They don't talk about the black women in business, in education, in medicine, even in entertainment. Those black women are winning. They go after black women who are in marginalized communities. So these men who go after black women in a negative fashion go after poor black women. The black women where they feel they're better than. They don't go after the black women that they can't compete with. So black women have to be more discerning about whom to listen to and whom to let affect you emotionally. Do not let people make you feel bad about what they're saying, because you don't know these people. You don't know their motive, and their motive is not going to be to your benefit. So do not listen to these people. Get off these low vibrational platforms with these low achieving people who don't want to get a real job. They want to blow up on social media so they won't have to go get a real job, because they're not trained to do anything. And maybe you need to start listening to empowered black women. These people on social media, whether they're black men, Latino men, white men, Asian men, these people can do black women no harm. They'll do well if they do something for themselves. And Latino people are the last people that need to be trying to talk about anybody. They need to be concerned about these laws that are being passed against them and make sure they have their papers in order. And if they are on the right trajectory, they are not on social media trying to drag anybody else down. So anyway, I hope that black women will understand that as we become more and more empowered, more people are going to try to eat off your plate. You've got to shut the door on some of these people. They don't mean you any good, and you're not going to gain anything by listening to their garbage. I thank the young lady for sending me the email and giving me this topic to discuss. And by all means, send me more stories. Contact me at LadyBoulet8596@gmail.com. Okay, y'all, thank you for listening. Let me know what you think about the video. Subscribe to the channel. Give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment. Share the video. And as always, have a great day.